Cooking with Plants, vegan made easy.
Hi everyone, it's Anja from Cooking with Plants and welcome to my kitchen. So for today's recipe, I actually want to share something that I made a couple of days ago and it's nearly all gone, and I want to share this with you before I eat it all. And it's actually for a nut free pesto sauce. So if you're allergic to nuts or you're trying to keep things lower fat and less calories, then this is a great option for you. It's fantastic to use with pasta or as a potato salad dressing or even just as a dip. So to start making this delicious pesto, add some chickpeas to a food processor or a blender. Then add a couple of handfuls of kale or spinach. I'm using organic washed and sliced kale for mine today. Also going in is a large bunch of fresh basil or basil that I got from the farmers markets, and that will add amazing flavour. A couple of dashes of white pepper, some fresh squeezed lemon juice, a couple of cloves of garlic, some delicious nutritional yeast flakes to add cheesy flavour, a tablespoon of white miso paste, and a splash of plant-based milk. Then give this a really good blend up. And be sure to scrape down the sides and then keep blending until it's all really well combined and creamy. And that's it, it's so simple. Once it's all blitzed up, it's ready to go, and you can thin it out with a little touch of maybe some fresh lemon juice, or even just add a little bit more of that plant-based milk into that to get it to the consistency that you like. But I really like to use this on some pasta. So when you're boiling your pasta, after you finish cooking, just reserve some of that water from the pasta that you've cooked, and that starchiness in the water will really make for a really lovely creamy pasta. So combine a little bit of that with this pesto and then put that over your pasta or your noodles, and it will make it absolutely delicious. So give it a try, let me know what you think. I absolutely love this, and I love that it doesn't use nuts. So if you do make this, share some photos on Instagram or come on over to my Facebook page or Facebook group where we share lots of photos and recipe ideas, tips and tricks. I'd love to have you there. So I look forward to seeing you for the next recipe. Bye for now.